Welcome back. Today we will see how to SSH into the EC2 instance using Linux. We can control a remote machine by using command line. SSH allows to remote into the EC2 instance using Linux machine. SSH is the most important function. As we have launched AMI Linux instance into our EC2 machine, and this AMI will be connected by remote through SSH command line interface. We have public IP address into our EC2 machine on which we have launched Linux. We need to copy public IP from here. And we have already allowed the SSH port 22 in our security groups. Let's see now. As you can see, I am using Windows machine, and from this machine we can use PowerShell, right? First, we need to verify that SSH is working or enabled on my Windows machine, and for that we have to open PowerShell and type here SSH, then hit the enter. Yes, we can see here the SSH command, all are good here. It means we can use it. Now we do SSH EC2-user@13.126.83.49. Here is the EC2-user, is basically the Linux user into our Amazon Linux machine, and define the IP address, then enter to continue. It says permission denied. That means we can't SSH into our machine. Why it is happening? If you have given here the public IP address and even the SSH port is open, actually this is more secure. It will not give access or allow to remote into our Amazon Linux machine without .pem file, that is PEM file, the security private key file which we have downloaded at the time of first Linux launch. That file will come to use here to get access into the Amazon Linux machine. Okay, so how we can do this? We will see it now. We have downloaded the .pem file in our download folder. We have to give here the path of that file to specify the private key file name. We have to run SSH command. SSH EC2-user@13.126.83.49. But with this, we have to reference my key so that it will allow me into the Linux machine. To use your key, we have to use the command ssh-i linux-server.pem, that is PEM, EC2-user@13.126.83.49. Then hit the enter. And now we get the another warning that shows unprotected private key file. Permission for this linux-server.pem are to open. It is required that your private key files are not accessible by others. And this will be ignored. Load key linux-server.pem have the bad permissions, and hence it gives permission denied. We have to check the PEM file properties. On that we will check the permission under security options. Here we need to remove all the users' names or the groups. We will go on advanced tab, and from here we will remove all the users who are having full control access to these files, and will disable the inheritance permission for all as well. We will apply the changes, then we need to change the owner of this file, but the owner name is already there, so we'll go to allow the full control permission by select a principal user from here. Click on OK, apply, then OK to complete this. Alright, we will do one more cross check that everything is fine. We can check the inheritance permission as well, that it shows it is disabled. Yes, all good here. Now we will run the same command here one more time. ssh-i linux-server.pem EC2-user@13.126.83.49 and hit the enter. Yeah guys, it is working now. As you can see here, we are into the Amazon Linux 2 AMI. Here you can see that last login date, and from this IP, it is my system IP address. Now we will try to ping microsoft.com. It is not allowing to ping this. Okay, we will go for google.com. Yes, it is started now. We can check who am I command, and it will show us that EC2 user. Right, that is the Linux user. Okay, now close this all and exit from PowerShell. Okay guys, here on this video we have seen how to SSH into the Amazon Linux machine and what things we have to take care of, like how to remove the inheritance permission for all the users from the PAM file and allow the permission for the same. We have done this for now and see you on my next video. Till then, have a great day and bye bye.